Good news for all women entrepreneurs out there. Telangana State Government had launched India's first state-level service exclusively for women entrepreneurs. Yes, it's WeHub that aims to be a platform that brings all alpha women kickstart their dream. It will lead by Deepthi Ravula, who says,
"So, tell me that how you are liking the assignment. Tell me about the assignment that we have
done. It's really lovely. I've been with the Department of Electronics for almost 2 years now. And I've been a joint director in the Department of Electronics. And our department actually does a lot of the, like, you know, land allocation and investment disbursements and things like that. We do a lot of incentive and subsidies disbursement. Investor meetings and things like that. But one thing which really caught us in the department is that not a lot of women actually entered our office. This in spite of their names being as directors and all that stuff. So then internally in the department, we are brainstorming for quite some time, and our Honorable Minister, Mr. KTR, also is very clued in to make sure that, you know, 50% of the workforce, which actually is women, also ramp up and become entrepreneurs. And that is how this entire idea of WeHub came about. And so I was asked to be the CEO of WeHub on the first week of February. And since then, it's been very exciting, actually. And what is really funny is that I think I've met more women from March 2018 through May 2018 than I've met since July 2016 to February 2018.
So more women are coming up to you and discussing the things they want to do.
Yes, because all these days, because there was no exclusive platform,
yeah,
women did not know where to go. Entrepreneurs did not know where to go.
That's true. Yeah.
But with the announcement of WeHub, they feel that, you know, there is a separate platform for them in the government itself, mm-hmm, where they can come in and understand more and voice their apprehensions, concerns, and get the support that they need. Yeah, it's been.
So how you are going to help them? What are the facilities? Tell me something.
So regarding the facilities, we're going to have a physical location in road number 45 in Jubilee Hills. It is in the TSAT office, which is in the B.R. Ambedkar Open University. So we have about 50 seats there where startups can actually come in and work. It's going to be a co-working space.
Okay.
In addition to that, we're going to be hosting a lot of the mentoring and networking events. And then what we are going to primarily also focus on is a lot of the virtual mentoring.
Okay.
What that means is, I have an office in Jubilee Hills, but not every entrepreneur from across the state has to be in my office, right?
Yes.
So we want to create a robust virtual incubation program by which they get all the benefits of an incubator, like, you know, networking, funding, and mentoring without physically having to be at our office.
Okay.
And the second thing we are going to be doing is actually operationalizing government schemes. So during the launch, our minister announced that, you know, incubatees at WeHub will get access to garment procurement. So we actually want to, like, you know, make sure that, you know, women understand how to run the entity, how to run a business, and how to actually get all the subsidies and incentives that they're actually rightfully deserving of.
Yeah.
And make sure that, you know, just train them on that. And the third thing we want to do is we want to reach out to the schools and colleges, girls, where women and girls are going to understand a little bit more about how to foster creativity, how to become entrepreneurs, and actually showcase role models. Maybe one day I'll invite you to come and speak to some students at Kasturba or something to showcase what it means to be a journalist.
Yeah.
Because today, a lot of us do not know what the professions out there are.
Yes,
they feel that it's, at least in Hyderabad, it's either engineer or doctor, right?
Yeah, mostly,
So we want to also, through WeHub, we want to bring more women role models and create a very strong network.
The other fields you are concentrating?
Every field.
Okay.
Everybody needs to know what options are there. Because, you know, there is a lot of other professions, a lot of wonderful entrepreneurs who are already there that women can take inspiration from.
So basically, you are the eligibility for your project.
Yes,
only
WeHub.
From Telangana?
No. It's from across the country, across the world.
Okay, anybody can apply here?
Anybody, any company where the primary stakeholder is a woman, the leader is a woman,
okay,
or the company has majority women is eligible to apply. Because we want to create a women focused center, not a women exclusive center, because men or women, they have to learn to work with each other.
Yeah.
So we want to make sure we create leaders who can work with anybody, and that is the goal for WeHub.
So you have got any criteria like middle class or, you know, lower middle class or upper class, that
the only thing,
income level is like that, them only we can help, or some like that, some
nothing like that. Okay. We are anyway here for any woman entrepreneur. That's all. Period. You might be the richest person, you might be from a different economic background, doesn't really matter to us. You need help, you come to WeHub. And that's why we are here, I'm here.
So. Yeah, everybody will come. Like,
yes, because, they should.
Yeah, but see, for everybody, 56, you told me just now, the number is very less.
Ah, so for that, right, one thing about entrepreneurship in general is that the 50 seats that are there in WeHub will actually be on basis of an application selection process that we've already begun online.
Yeah.
So when I say anybody can come in, we are actually partnering with every other incubator in Telangana, in Hyderabad. Mm. Like, you know, NAM, which is the A Idea, which is an incubator at NAM. Mm. Then we are also going to partner with, like, you know, other academic incubators that are in the city. So if we don't have space, we already have our partners who can actually give
you
them space.
And
yes, yes,
right,
yes.
Right. Mm-hmm. So now just tell me, being a woman, mm-hmm, what is your message to the other women who wants to be entrepreneur and who wants, because you're helping, you're extending, mm-hmm, your help, mm-hmm, as a woman to other,
yes,
women. Lots of women nowadays, they are shy, or some, I have seen particularly, they don't have that confidence enough to go and do the things, you know, if they want to do, are very skillful also. So just keep
One line answer is, please come meet us at WeHub, because we are here. And we are also going to be doing a lot of the personality development, communication skills. And we have a wonderful entity in our government called as TASK, which is Telangana Academy for Skills and Knowledge, which actually trains people in communication skills and the soft skills that are needed.
Mm-hmm.
So that is a wonderful entity that we have. So we can actually request for their help in training them. And the second thing is that all the things that you pointed out are actually internal inhibitions that we have as women. We do have them. So the only way to actually overcome them is just going and doing it. If you're scared of doing something, just go do it anyway, because, you know, the more you try to be scared of things, there'll be fewer things for you to do. So that's all. Yeah.
Do you think still there is a gender bias?
I believe so. Yeah. But I've been very fortunate not to have faced it. The reason is, if you look around this office,
yeah,
we have about how many? 40 employees, and I'm the only woman. So I don't know if it is gender bias, but yeah, there is a low representation from women. Absolutely. I would not call it a bias.
Mm-hmm.
It's more like underrepresentation. That's all.
So any uncomfortable situation being a boss of a male gender?
I think you should ask them. I'm very comfortable. Ask him. He is. He's,
yeah,
like,
because sometimes a male, they feel like, okay, she is dominating us, she is ordering us.
You know, the beauty.
Somewhere you have felt like, no, because he is feeling some egoistic. Like.
Yeah, 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 yeah. It's very common.
Yeah.
But the beauty is that the beauty is that, yeah, it's very common. But the only way to kind of overcome or kind of, you know, is to have a conversation. That's it. Because they are here for work, I'm here for work. We are both working together. At the end of the day, it's work that needs to get done.
That's it.
Doesn't really matter if it's a man, woman, child, who cares, right? You're here for a work, job, get it done.
Very true.
That's it.
Very true.
Quality of work.
Just now you were discussing, I just heard that you tie up with some other state and all these things. Tell me something about that.
Sorry?
You are going to tie up with some other people who are really encouraging women, or some organization,
yes,
some company,
yes,
or
yes,
some NGOs, whatever.
Yes. So we are trying to work with many of the organizations in the country. Like, let's take our city, Hyderabad. So we have many organizations like, you know, CII. We have organizations like FICCI. We have organizations like COVI, ALEAP. so many wonderful organizations. So one of the things we are trying to do with them is actually, like CII, we are going to do a women in workforce kind of a policy. And the main thing is that they will be our knowledge partner in getting a policy out. So we're going to seek out their assistance in doing things.
Yeah.
That is one. And the other thing is we are also going to reach out to technology organizations like the one I was just talking to.
Yes, yes.
So the reason is, again, to encourage more women to come into, like, you know, technological fields and, you know, accomplish something and create value for society.
This exclusive interview is brought to you by Riaan TV Bureau.